cold and start feeling mixed signals like Morse code. My soul start to grow colder than the North Pole. I try to focus on the hole of where the torch goes, in the tradition of these legendary sports pros. As far as I can see, I've made it to the threshold. Lord knows I've waited for this a lifetime, and I'm an icon when I let my light shine. Shine bright as an example of a champion, taking the advantage, never copping out or canceling. Burn like a chariot, learn how to carry it. Maverick, always above and beyond average. Fuel to the flame that I train with and travel with. Something in my eyes say I'm so close to having a prize. I realize I'm supposed to reach for the skies. Never let somebody try to tell you otherwise. One game, one desire, one flame, one bonfire, let it burn higher. I never show signs of fatigue or turn tired, cause I'm the definition of tragedy turned triumph. It's David and Goliath, I made it to the eye of the storm, feeling torn like they fed me to the lions. Before my time start to wind down like the Mayans, I show them how I got to grind down like a science. It sounds like a riot on hush, it's so quiet, the only thing I hear is my heart. I'm inspired by the challenge that I find myself standing eye to eye with, the move like a wise warrior and not a coward. You can't escape the history that you was meant to make. That's why the highest victory is what I'm meant to take. You came to celebrate, I came to celebrate. I hate losing, I refuse to make the same mistakes.
glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Old school versus new school. Power and ISO versus pitch and catch. Get the athletes out in space. These two teams have contrasting styles, contrasting philosophies. One team obsessed with time of possession. The other one could care less about it. Who establishes its tempo will be a key today. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Next to the State Fairgrounds at Carter-Finley Stadium, where these two teams are poised to do battle. And now let's head down to the coin toss, brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Central Michigan is lined up for the opening kickoff. So here we go. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And he's stopped behind the line.
That makes it second and 14.
From their own 21-yard line, second down.
Mike 17.
Check.
Caught out of the open, and they push him out at the 25. A screen pass, gets it to the back, and down he goes around the 40-yard line. It's first and 10, ball on the 40-yard line. Makes it out to about the 49. Makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Run play and he'll lose yards.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That makes it third and 11.
Man left.
Four down.
Mike 17.
And he tackles him hard at the 47-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
That makes it fourth and 8.
This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game. Central Michigan staff and their fans have heard all week long their quarterback's going to play terribly on the road. I think their staff's got them ready to prove them wrong right now.
I think this staff really has rallied this entire team around some of that negative talk, and I think they believe in their guy that he can go on the road and make the plays and lead them to a big victory. You know, sometimes when you hit some adversity like that, you see teams circle the wagons, and I really believe this week they've done a great job of doing that. Now they just have to go out and execute the plan and go out and win this game.
To the 20. And he's tackled at the 8-yard line. That was a nice play.
You know, we talk about this every week, adjusting to the blitz. The quarterback and the receiver do an excellent job of recognizing the blitz and adjusting to the play. Good-looking pass.
So now it's first and goal after the big pass play. Go with the run, and he's tackled in the backfield for a loss. Central Michigan's got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinator. And they'll bring him down behind the line.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
It's third and goal. Ball on the 12. Throwing right. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
Has some daylight.
He's to the 40, the 50, and he's taken down around the 44-yard line.
That's a gain of 32 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
So it's first and 10 after the big run. He launches one for the end zone. Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. He makes his way out to about the 35. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Hey, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Watch the screen. Yeah.
Each time you run an option, a big play is possible. This time they came up big on third down.
To the wideout, first down. The senior makes the catch. Touchdown, Central Michigan.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
Boy, that had to be a miscue of some kind or a mental error by the defense. This wide receiver was just too open for their not. I'm sure the defensive coordinator is going to want to get his defense on the sideline and to make sure everybody's on the same page. And I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Central Michigan up 7 points. wants it all, going long. Brought down at about the 13. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. Around the 11-yard line. That's good for the 2 yards. That makes it second and 8. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 10-3, Central Michigan. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. It's third and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. Quickly to the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown. How about the tight end? This guy can play some football.
You bet he can. He's such an all-around player. He's just as good at blocking as he is at catching the football.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Airing it out long.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 48. They get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 4 on the play. That'll bring up 36.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38.
Two down. Mike one.
Two. He's scrambling. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
Quick thinking there. You know, they're liable to put the ball in the air on third, so it's
the defense forced a turnover on downs on the last drive.
Nothing can impact an offense more negatively than being stopped on a series of downs. And that's what happened to this offense the last time they were out. It's not just the quarterback's job to try to get this offense going. I think it starts up front with a veteran offensive line. See what kind of leadership they have to try to change this thing around.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 24-yard line. There's a strike complete. He's taken down at the 45-yard line, and a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Second and five.
From midfield,
It's second down. Tackle made at the 47. Yard line.
So they pick up the first on the option. Not a lot of room there.
They go to the option here. He picks up just enough for the first, and you're right. There wasn't much running room there.
From the 44-yard line, first down. He heaves it deep. Through his hands.
That's just a great play to separate the ball from the receiver. He'll be feeling that hit tomorrow.
That makes it second and 10.
First and goal. First down, and they'll bring it up first and goal inside the five. A short yardage defense here. Touchdown, Chippewas.
To the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Once and all, going deep. And they make the stop at the 19-yard line.
First down.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line. We played a half. The Chippewas in front, 24-9.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just teams has been totally negated in the first half. Neither team has been able to come up with a sack. So what's the D-line coach right now preaching to you guys up front, you big fellas who love to go there and make life miserable for a quarterback?
Well, you got to watch the football and get off it as soon as you can and try to get that first step quickness, because I know those guys are big and strong, but they're also a little bit chunky. And if you're on the defensive line and you're a little bit slimmer and you get off the football a little bit faster, but try to get off that ball quick. And it's not just sacks, Reese. How about you affect the quarterback? How about you bull rush your guy and you put him in his lap and you make him throw over top, or, you know, change the throwing angle so he doesn't have a clean pocket where he can step up in there and make big throws the whole game. You got to do something different than you did the first half to affect the quarterback.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
Now he's scrambling.
He's out of bounds at the 50.
Well, this is a nice run for the first down by this quarterback.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
That'll make it second and 9.
The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Quick strike to the receiver, and he's tackled right away. First and 10, ball on the 39. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. He's at the 30, he's at the 20. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal.
Gain of 30 yards. That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Can't bring him down, and he's in. And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get...
Quick throw, picked off, and down he goes at about the 19-yard line.
What kind of call is that? With a big lead, interception here could end up costing you.
The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
He chucks it downfield. Got it to the senior. And he's leveled at the 32-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
Is complete. He's got room to work. He steps out around the 30-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. And he's tackled at the 18.
That makes it first and 10.
Inside the 10. Gets out to around the 6.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
First and goal from the 5. They're knocking on the door. Three-yard gain by the running back.
And there's not much he could do to get away from the junior safety on that play.
That brings him second and goal.
Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D.
Touchdown, Central Michigan.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
They keep it on the ground with the tailback. He's pushed out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
From their own 28-yard line, it's first down.
Second and two.
This offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Here we go.
He's at midfield. Makes it out to about the 46.
There's a reason why defenses hate playing against teams that run the option well. It's so unpredictable. That time they couldn't defend it properly and they gave up a first down.
He'll take it all the way for the touchdown.
I can guarantee you'll be seeing that one in the highlight reels. What a great, great run. A real display of all the tools that he brings to the table. You know, in this day and age with the spread and so many offenses being in such a hurry, how refreshing is it to watch an offense just kind of go old school, line up, blow people off the line of scrimmage, and just assert themselves with their personality?
I expect him to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
From their own 23-yard line, second down. Central Michigan comes to the line. They got a big advantage in this one. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it third and three.
To admire the effort to make sure he got every last foot he needed to pick up the first down.
From their own 33-yard line, first down. Again with a carry. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Great tackle at the 32. That brings up third and 10. And here's another third down. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Down at the 48-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. He's hit and got away. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up third and 2.
Well, they'll line it up again on third down. 2 for 2 so far on this drive. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass.
We're late in the fourth quarter. This game has been a blowout for quite some time, and Kirk and I are just looking to make our flights. Gets out to around the 25.
Gaining 9 yards. That brings up second and 1.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and 1. At the 27-yard line. Central Michigan staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happy.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.
glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Central Michigan's been hitting on all cylinders the last few games. They've ripped off a string of W's, trying to extend that streak, but the key is keeping Big Mo on your side. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's tackled around the 27-yard line. Central Michigan's got a kid who is playing fantastic this year, and he's garnering national attention. You sit down. Very special. There's really no surprise he's among the nation's elite right now. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down. And they make the stop around the 28-yard line. Richardson only gets about a yard there on the option keeper. The 43-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 43. They hand it off, and they'll get him in the backfield. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
And once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Throws it deep.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into cover. Throw it away out of bounds.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Made at about the 43-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
From the 43-yard line, first down. And he's tackled at the 40.
77.
He's on the run. And he has it on the corner. He's pushed out of bounds around the 35-yard line. Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
He's a real good field general for this offense. He can beat you in any number of ways.
Deep pass to the end zone.
That close to being intercepted.
The defense had a chance here, Brad, to just end the drive. An interception there. They get the football back and a lot of momentum.
From the 31-yard line, it's second down. In the shotgun and five wideouts. And down he goes at the 16-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
First and 10, ball on the 16. This offense has really stalled on their last two trips to the red zone. The 10, the 5, touchdown Chippewas. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Central Michigan is up by six. Gets it out to the tight end, and he can't hang on.
This is the intended receiver of the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 45-yard line, second down. Makes the first down catch, and he's taken down at the 30-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
They'll bring him down at the 22.
Makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
Gain 3 yards. First down.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. And he hits him hard at the 12. Central Michigan with a 6-point lead. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That makes it first and goal.
and this is the eighth play of the drive. For the corner. He's gobbled up in the backfield. So the halfback loses about two on the run.
Great penetration into the backfield, and that was just a great hit to finish off the play.
That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the nine. He's under pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Tenth play of the drive. Throws in a hurry. Off his hands, incomplete. We're about set to start things up again. Brought down at the 36.
That's good for gain of 10 yards. First down.
From their own 36-yard line. First down. That's a great tackle at the 30. We played one quarter. The Chippewas in front, 9-0. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. He throws left. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. From their own 30-yard line. Third down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. They bring him down.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, the ball away.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Tackled at the 31-yard line.
He was never able to get ahead of steam on that carry.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 31-yard line. On play action, throws, end zone. This one will fall incomplete. He's at the 20. He's tackled in the open field.
Called a gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 19-yard line, it's first down. They'll drop him for a loss. The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
That'll make it 35.
So we're looking at another third down here.
Now he's scrambling. He's going to take off. Touchdown, Central Michigan.
The offense will take the field, and they've been moving the ball very well on their last couple of drives.
He lets it fly. Almost picked off.
Boy, this is a great play by the safety to be able to be in a position to make this play. But he's got to be able to hold on to the football. You know, he's a big, physical, athletic guy, but you've got to be able to secure a football and make a big play when it presents itself.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. He's tackled at the 44-yard line.
Number 21 brings him down at the 44-yard line. First down.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. First down.
Pulls it in, and that's a first down. Has it to the senior. And they make the stop around the 23-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 23-yard line, first down. Play fake. Here comes the defense. And he can't get away from the pressure. There's sack number 4.
Well, he's being forced to make really quick decisions because he doesn't have any time to throw the ball. That's going to lead to turnovers.
Roger, Roger.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Caught, and this is going to be a first down.
Receiver, and not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play. Brad, the wide receiver was the key here. He did a really good job of working to the post. He kind of looked off the defender to the outside and then moved back to the middle of the field, and the quarterback recognized the big hole in the defense and made the throw for the touchdown.
6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
They come up to the line here. It's second down and 14 after the sack. Under heavy pressure. Knocked out of bounds at the 26.
Right, left, right, left.
Sullivan was the intended receiver on the play, and that'll make it fourth down.
The defense held their ground on that play.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Central Michigan is up by eight. They run it left. Tackled outside after a nice pickup.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 28-yard line, second down. Fires out to his wideout, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 42.
That's a gain of 14 yards on the play. First down.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Makes it to the 34.
Brings him down. That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down.
First down, Graham. He's taken down right around the 10-yard line.
That's a good pick for him, 24 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 10-yard line, first down. He makes it out to about the 8-yard line. Well, Kirk, good news. We saw him go to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, but apparently he's all right. It looks like he's going to get back in the action here. Central Michigan holds an 8-point advantage. Up the middle for a nice game. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. They're crowding the line.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
The offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
That's a deep 10 on the ball. First down.
From their own 18-yard line, it's first down. Caught, and that's a first down. He's out to the 30, and he's tackled around the 45-yard line.
Gain of 37 yards. First down.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Four-yard line.
Gain of 1 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Tackle made at the 41-yard line. third and five situation. Ball on the 41. Well, this turned out to be a pretty good ball game, and we've got one quarter to go. Central Michigan's up by 15. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He's at the 30, caught, and he's taken down around the 26-yard line.
Number 24 makes the tackle at the 26-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. Deep ball, laying it out there. Oh, he had a shot at the pick.
Dixon was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
I got one.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Here's the eighth play of the series. From the 3-yard line, it's second down. A short yardage defense here. They'll bring him down at the 3-yard line. This is the 10th play of this drive. Brought down right around the 2-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He makes it to the 32-yard line.
That makes it 7-8.
From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. After positive yardage.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. Third down.
Here he goes. Inside the 30. The 10. And he will score.
This offense just has so many weapons to defend. They've got some genuine playmakers.
He
These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another six on the board here.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
And he is drilled at the 31.
That's a deep nine on the play. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 7 yards. First down.
Inside the 10.
What a play, and that is first and goal.
Gain of 16 yards. That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Flies over the goal line for the touchdown. That's a huge touchdown on the ground, Herbie. That might do it. I'm sure that touchdown and their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
At the 37.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and nine.
From the 37-yard line, second down. On play action, throws, end zone. It's broken up.
The coaches have to be ecstatic with that kind of effort from the corner. No quit, no getting beat on that long pass.
Under a minute left. Once and all, going deep. The defender had it and then dropped it.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with a pick.
And the defense stopped them cold on fourth down during their last drive.
Brad, this offense, the last time they were out there, went for it on fourth down and came up short. And I'm all for being aggressive, but I really think you've got to be smart when it comes to when to go for it on fourth down and when to punt and try to affect field position. Let's see if this offensive coordinator and play caller has learned from some of his mistakes in the past.
Central Michigan staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Chippewas have not only put together a nice winning streak, they're starting to play at a much higher level, and they've energized their entire campus. Now the question is, will they be able to handle everybody on campus, patting them on the back, telling them how good they are, and telling them how they expect a big win in this one? We've done all we can do here. Time to tee it up. Let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for the call. David and I will be with you at halftime.
Ohio for this football game, and there's an energetic crowd awaiting the opening kickoff. Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. And they make the stop at the 25. And there's a penalty on the play. Let's see who it's on.
Holding. Offense.
Central Michigan's got a guy that statistically is... conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinator. So first down once again, but a long ways to go after that penalty. And he's going to be sacked.
It's a big-time effort sack by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
It's second down and a long way to go. Ball on their own 8. Almost intercepted there.
Well, the offense catches a break here. That ball should have been intercepted there by the safety, so the quarterback gets the ball back here for this next down.
They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Now he's scrambling. He chucks it downfield. Gets it. He's in space. Down the sideline. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 44-yard line.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. It cannot let these receivers get behind them.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. They'll bring him down at the 45. At the 30 to the 20. Touchdown, Chippewas. Oh.
out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
And they hit him in the backfield.
Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison.
From their own 19-yard line, second down. Central Michigan is up seven. He's in trouble. It's a fumble, and the ball bounces out of bounds.
The ball just kept scooting all over the place on the sideline, and it finally skipped out of bounds before anybody could claim it.
And down he goes at the 41-yard line.
You like to see a team having success like this running the football. It can really open up things for the offense.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. Here they come. Gets it out in a hurry. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. At midfield. He gets hit out of bounds at the 46.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run, and that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Under pressure. Throwing on the run. Finds his fullback. He's tackled around the 43-yard line. Central Michigan is up a score. Gets rid of it quickly. And that one's incomplete. He led his wide receiver too far to the outside.
Yeah, he just had to pull the string a little bit more there.
From the 43-yard line, it's third down. Tries to fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted. And he is drilled at the 36.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happened.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Little handoff. Gets to around the 42.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 42. After positive yardage.
That brings him second and five.
Brought down at the 44.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. First down.
First and 10, ball on the 44. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
Let's get off the field.
Let's taken down at the 25-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 25. Central Michigan up 7 points. Throws on the run, complete. And he's tackled around the 18-yard line.
Game 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
Complete. He's got room. He steps up at the 8.
You know, having a playmaker at tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Another run. Tackle around the 7-yard line.
That's a deep run. That brings up second and goal.
This is the 8th play of this drive. Richardson takes a handoff, and he's going to come up with a sack. From the 21-yard line, third down.
Plain and simple. If he doesn't come in with a hard hit to knock the ball free, that's a touchdown.
That brings up fourth and goal.
They picked up 3 points on their last possession, and they've got great field position to work from here. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 28. Quick throw. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
The pass falls incomplete. Dixon was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it 3-5.
Made right around the 18-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and 6.
Taken down around the 2-yard line.
Call it a gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and goal.
First down. First and goal. You're going to go play action inside the 5. Here's the time to do it. Defense stacked in tight here. Runs through a defender, and he's in. Score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your... When you're a quarterback and you start this close to the end zone, your eyes just light up when you take the field. Conversely, the defense is thinking, uh-oh, we can't let him get another one so quickly.
He gets out to about the 14-yard line.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 14.
Four down, four down. Mark shift 33.
in trouble. Caught with room to work. And he's level at the 8-yard line.
Gain of six on the play. That'll make it second and four.
He's got the corner. He fights forward to about the 7. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And they make the stop at the 4-yard line.
First and goal.
Watch 85. Ball zone 85. Watch 85.
Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Touchdown, Central Michigan. And that's his second touchdown of the day.
Plays like that are just hard to stop. Once this young man gets on the move, it's highlight time.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. He fights forward to about the 23. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 23. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
Job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they
the offense ready for the first play of this drive. They moved the ball extremely well on their last possession on their way to the end zone. Central Michigan with a big advantage. Runs left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's got to be very frustrating for that running back. This offense is trying to get in sync and trying to get a rhythm.
It's second down, 12 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. He sails it long.
Right now, this quarterback, when he's calling play action, is doing a good job of selling the run fake. He's not tipping his hand at all that it's a play action pass. He's doing a good job of selling the run fake, which is getting the defense out of position and making it much easier to throw the football.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10.
Four down.
Mike check, 33.
Down. Blue 90.
He fights forward to about the 33. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 33. And he's got him again. They'll bring him down
right around the 14-yard line. And for Dixon, his receiving numbers keep getting more and more gaudy.
Over the course of an entire year, you're going to take some shots when you catch as many passes as he does. But he's always been able to bounce back for more yards.
First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 14-yard line. Central Michigan
comes to the line holding that commanding lead.
They get on the board again. Touchdown.
He just put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
This one has been a blowout since the beginning. Hopefully the fourth quarter will turn things around.
Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
From their own 22-yard line, second down.
He gets to about the 31-yard line.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Fires it out. Big opening. To the 20. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal.
The game's not over until the final whistle blows, no matter what the scoreboard says. The defense needs to remember that, or this is only going to get worse.
There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. So after the big pass play, we have a first and goal. Central Michigan looking to put this game away if they score here. Good outside run there.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That brings up second and goal.
We've got second and goal. 3 yards for the touchdown. They put everyone up on the line. And there's another one.
That is great, tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
I expect them to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
There's a very impressive open field tackle.
First down.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. Central Michigan up big. And down he goes at the 47.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
makes his way to about the 45.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. First down.
From the 45-yard line, it's first down. Runs outside for a nice gain.
Gain of 5 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Four down, four down.
Mike check 33.
He makes his way to about the 32.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it first and 10.
From the 32-yard line, first down.
Hey, check my 33, check my 33.
Ready!
He's at the 20. He's knocked out of bounds at the 15. Another carry for this kid, and he'll get the first down.
He's carrying this offense on his back right now, and I think they'll keep giving him the ball until the defense figures out a way to stop him.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 15. Central Michigan in control. The 10. The 5. He's tackled at the 1 yard line.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. That makes it first and goal.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Brought down around the 1 yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings him second and goal.
From the 1 yard line, it's second down. Touchdown, Chippewas. Well, at this point, these guys are just out there padding stats and running up the score.
Sometimes you play in a game. Seems like they've been in a rhythm since we kicked this game off.
Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home, and Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. He's to the 40. Gets out to around the 48.
That's a team of 17 on the play. First down.
Tackled at the 49-yard line.
Personal foul. Basement. Defense.
And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Central Michigan with a commanding lead. And he is drilled at the 31-yard line. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. Central Michigan, 52. Ohio, 3. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.
everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. A lot of times, if we say tempo is the key, you think that we're talking about basketball. No, tempo is a huge key in this game. We're going to be back at halftime. How long that takes sort of depends on who establishes its tempo. The running team controls the way and bleeds that clock. We'll see you in just a few minutes. Passing team pitches it all over the place and runs up numbers on that scoreboard. Might be a while, but we'll still be here. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Chippewa River in Mount Pleasant, Michigan, the battlefield for this college football contest.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. And he's taken down at the 44-yard line.
Once this guy gets into the secondary, he can be a real problem to bring down. He can shake off a lot of tacklers who are smaller than he is.
First and 10 after the big pass play. They'll run it. Tackle made at about the 43-yard line. Central Michigan's got a kid who is playing fantastic this year, and he's garnering national attention. You sit down with this kid, he's very special. There's really no surprise he's among the nation's elite right now. Throw. Tackle at the 40-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 34.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop around the 23-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Central Michigan. He got the handoff and knew exactly what to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick his way so well through defenses.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
He's taken down at about the 35.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 35-yard line. Nice catch on that one. And he tackles him hard at the 49.
I'm sure the coaches are going to tell him to calm down and be more careful, because I guarantee you, nobody keeps throwing those passes into the defense like that without making a mistake.
Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. It's second and six. Ball on the 47-yard line. And down he goes at about the 37-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Knocked out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Play of this drive. He's scrambling. Slides down to the ground. First and 10. Ball on the 14-yard line. Setting up play action. He's out of bounds at the 5-yard line. And this is the 10th play of the drive. For the second time today.
That was just an excellent individual effort to find the end zone. Now, I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
First and 10, ball on the 48. Central Michigan is up by a touchdown. Fakes the handoff. Defense coming. And they got it.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
To that quick, and it's going the other way.
Really impressed with this guy's closing speed on the ball. He's got the...
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Nice run to the left there.
That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. The 37-yard line.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
From their own 37-yard line, second down. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That'll make it 35.
He's tackled around the 35-yard line. From the 35-yard line, first down. He launches one for the end zone. Missed him. At the 20. He's tackled at the 5. That gives him a total of 100 yards on his carry so far.
Here's a guy that just seems to really welcome the pressure and the big moment. This is a big time game. It's a close game, and he continues to deliver for his football team.
First and goal from the 5. They're knocking on the door. Touchdown, Central Michigan.
Shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming in, but they just couldn't stop it. I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning, where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Central Michigan is up a score. Runs it left for a decent gain.
That makes it second and six.
Brought down at the 49-yard line. From their own 49-yard line, it's third down.
Check down.
cavalry's coming. He's at the 40. He goes out of bounds at the 37. Got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From the 37-yard line, it's second down. Five wide. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Central Michigan is up 7. Touchdown, Chippewa. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That brings up 2nd and 9.
From their own 19-yard line, it's 2nd down. And they get nice yardage on that run. He makes his way out to about the 35. It's 1st and 10. Ball on their own 35. Nice run, and he's brought down. In trouble, and they get the sack.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play, and as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of it. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
And he's going to come up with a sack. Great job, back-to-back plays by the defense.
These hits take a toll on a quarterback.
Here comes the offense as they look to find the end zone yet again. He makes his way to about the 28. First and 10. Ball on the 28. Knocked out of bounds around the 39-yard line. Fires out to his receiver, and he's taken down around the 47-yard line
And for Dixon, his receiving yards are a new single-season record for this team.
When was the last time we saw somebody get downfield the way this guy does? And it isn't just a speed thing. He's simply an exceptional runner.
From the 47-yard line, first down.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made right around the 28-yard line. From the 28-yard line, first down. Picked off.
Yeah, the quarterback's breathing a huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
He's at the 20. Inside the 10. He scores. What a play.
This kid is incredible. He's got the moves, the speed, the power. He's the total.
Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. And he is drilled at the 41. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41. And they make the stop at about the 39-yard line.
Gain of two on the play. That'll bring up third and eight.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29. Gets it out in a hurry.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Now he's scrambling. And he's sacked.
You have to keep an eye on this guy, especially during passing situations, because he does a great job of getting to the quarterback, as we saw right there.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. They come out on an empty backfield. They bring him down.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he's playing a little bit better.
Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. He's taken down at about the 41.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
From the 41-yard line, it's first down. And down he goes at about the 43-yard line. One more quarter to play. This one appears to be well under control. Central Michigan's got a 3-touchdown advantage. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Complete. He's hammered.
That makes it 37.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. Quick throw. They'll bring him down around the 22-yard line.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Man left, man left. Go down.
On the ground with the tailback. They bring him down in the backfield.
That's the 5 yards on the play. That makes it 2nd and 14.
Second down, 14 coming up here. Ball on the 27-yard line. Play fake, and he fires end zone. Incomplete.
Sullivan was the intended receiver on the play. That brings up 3rd and 14.
And once again, they'll come to the line, try to convert on 3rd down. Gets it out quickly. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a 1st and goal. Here's the 8th play of the series. Makes it to the 6-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That brings up 2nd and goal.
Second down and goal. Ball on the 6-yard line. They get on the board again. Touchdown.
kid's having. Four rushes have ended in touchdowns.
We wondered if the linebackers...
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Central Michigan comes to the line holding that commanding lead. He's at the 20. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 5-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And he's tackled at the 3-yard line. Hopefully he's going to be okay. Put everyone up on the line. And there's another one. Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home, and Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. He's at the 30. He might have a chance. He steps out at the 17-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 17-yard line. Tackles at the 19.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
Central Michigan with a commanding lead. Throws.
Have you ever heard of sportsmanship? You've got a huge lead and you're still throwing the football. Boy, this time is incomplete, which stops the clock. I'm going to start pulling for the defense to get back into this game.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end.
That makes it 4-12.
And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. Central Michigan, 49. Northern Illinois, 24. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Central Michigan's been on a roll lately, but a winning streak is only important if it continues to be a winning streak. By extending it, we'll see if they can get it done in this one. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
The site for what should be a great game of college football.
Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game.
And he hits him hard at the 21-yard line. 2-yard carry by the fullback.
There was simply no daylight on that play. The defender came in and dropped the hammer.
From their own 21-yard line, second down. They go to the ground game. He's tackled
at about the 23-yard line.
Central Michigan's not only looking to win this one, but they could set some records along the way. I mean, that's secondary to the real work. First of all, you want to win the football game.
And they make the stop at the 32.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
From their own 32-yard line, first down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
Around the 49-yard line.
Kirk, he's really got a lot of confidence in his receivers.
Yeah, I think he does, but in this case, I think he just threw it up for grabs. He thinks his receiver can make the catch no matter how many guys are hanging on his back.
From their own 49-yard line, first down.
He goes downtown. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
This is the eighth play of this drive. He's taken down
at about the 49.
A yard, maybe two on the carry.
Down now, and they need to get it inside the 41.
Come on.
into that quickly. Tackle made around the 35-yard line.
I love to see this quarterback respond when this offense really needs him to pick him up. Your quarterback's performance on third down is vital to your team's success.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds. From the 23-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down at about the 21. At the 12th play of the drive. Here comes the pressure, and he is drilled at the 27-yard line.
Wow, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those, as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out, because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
Another third down upcoming, and they've converted all three this drive. Five wide. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Touchdown! Big play!
The wide out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful. One of the things a quarterback's looking for before the ball is snapped on a post route is to see if he has one field. Because with one safety, you can use your eyes to move that safety and then throw back the other way for the touchdown. I thought the quarterback that time did a really good job of managing that safety and eventually making the throw for the touchdown.
Central Michigan with a 6-point lead. And down he goes, right around the 30. Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. First and 10, ball on the 30. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Taken down right around the 46-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 46. Throws. Oh, what an interception.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular.
We'll have to see now how the offense responds this time after throwing a pick on their last drive.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
And they get the sack.
What a really good call here by the defensive coordinator. Perfect time to dial up the blitz. The blitz didn't get home, but it did free up a defensive lineman to get to the quarterback to come up with that sack.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Central Michigan is up by 6.
Brett, this gives you an indication of his versatility. He's a physical linebacker that a lot of times is up trying to stuff the run, but he has ability to be able to make plays in space, and this time he climbs the ladder and knocks that ball away.
They come out on an empty backfield.
Now he tries to buy some time. Airing it out long.
Doesn't get there. And that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a...
That makes it open.
It had to be open.
The defense was able to stop this offense short on fourth down last time. Let's see what they do this opportunity.
Hey, remember, you don't have to go for it on fourth down. The last time you had the football, you went for it on fourth down, and you didn't convert. Just think about this. If you move the ball into your opponent's territory and you want to take a chance and it makes sense to go for it on fourth down, I understand that and I get it. But when you're in your own territory and it's fourth down and five or longer, just considering the punt would make me so happy.
Fires to the wideout, first down. Brought down at the 25.
Game 54 on the way. First down.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That makes it second and 6.
Central Michigan up 6. For a nice game.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up third and inches.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Gets to about the 14-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it first and 10. First and goal.
First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. Defense and their short yardage package.
Touchdown, Central Michigan.
Strength to run it when you're heading into a massive pile of bodies. Good job.
They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
And they push him out at the 33-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long-range yards.
First and 10, ball on the 33. Herbie, this guy headed to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. We don't know how bad it is, but right now it doesn't look like he's likely to play any more football.
Heading for the corner. He gets to about the 41-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it
it second and two.
He's at midfield. Gains his way to the 40-yard line.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 40.
Fires to his receiver, first down.
Number 14 on the tackle at the 27-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
In the shotgun and five wideouts. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
That's a deep 19 play. That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Run to the outside.
Gaining five on the play. That brings up second and goal.
A short yardage defense here. Touchdown, Chippewas.
The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
To the 20, the 10, and he will score.
You hate to say that a game is over so early, but unless they make some incredible changes and fast, I just don't see how they can come back from this.
It's still only the second quarter. We got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Central Michigan is winning big. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line. From their own 31-yard line, second down. We've played a half. The Chippewas in front, 27-0. Taking the field again now is the offense, and I got to tell you, these guys have just been a defensive nightmare on the past few drives. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
That's good. That'll make it second and seven.
Second and seven. Ball on the 21. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. At the 30.
to the 10.
They get on the board again. Touchdown.
They pretty much had their way with the defense there. Terrific play. I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, six to go. Ball on their own 21. Central Michigan comes to the line holding that commanding lead. Quick out to his receiver. He's tackled at the 32.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. First down.
And they make the stop right around the 34. Second down and eight. Ball on 34. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Gain of 7 yards. Third down.
Field. Tackle at about the 37-yard line.
To be successful, you've got to be able to come through on third down, and that's just what they did with that big run.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37. Makes it out to about the 29.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and two.
They go with a run, and he's taken down behind the line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Central Michigan looking to put this game away if they score here. And they get nice yardage on that run.
A gain of 6 yards. That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 24. Play action, throws, end zone.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
That makes it second and 10.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Scrambling around.
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack, but somehow he's able to throw the ball away.
They line up for another third down, and they've had no problem converting their first two. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Zings it over the middle. Touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
You know, if a quarterback has a strong arm, one of his favorite routes is the post. But I thought the quarterback...
to open up that void in the defense, and then he made the good throw to the receiver for the touchdown.
Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
I expect him to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
Got an opening. The 50. Down the sideline. The 10. He's all the way. Touchdown.
He's having quite a game. Three rushing touchdowns now.
Boy, this guy's been huge today. It's been a big part of the reason that his team has the lead. You know, the defensive line psyche right now is a little fragile. They better start to make some plays to start to regain their confidence, because right now they're just getting pushed around.
They just seem like they've been in the end zone time and time again. There's not much negative you can say about this performance.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 6.
They line up at the 7. It's 2nd down. Central Michigan with a big advantage. Runs outside for a nice game. It's 3rd down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that 1st down marker. They'll bring him down right around the 14-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. 1st down.
To about the 31-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First and 10. Ball on their own 31. Taken down around the 32-yard line.
That brings up 2nd and 9.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Central Michigan comes to the line. They got a big advantage in this one. Fights forward to about the 33. So we're looking at another 3rd down here. Throw, he caught it. He's into the open field. And down he goes at the 25-yard line.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Now it's 1st and 10 after the big pass play.
Three down, three down. Mike 40, Mike 40.
up a yard of anything on that run.
No gain on the play. That brings up second and nine.
This is the ninth play of this drive. And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
So far this drive, the defense has been unable to stop them on third down. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. He's under pressure. Well, the stop made there late in the fourth quarter, but this game's been over almost since the beginning. And I think it's time for everybody to head to the locker room. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Deep pass to the end zone. Incomplete. Almost picked off. And they'll take over on downs. Central Michigan staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happy.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.